Hello, my name is Allie, and today I'm going to explain how to create a SmartArt graphic. As Microsoft states, quote, SmartArt graphics quickly create designer quality diagrams, charts, and other informational graphics. SmartArt graphics can be used to provide information easily in a visual representation. The ability to create a SmartArt graphic is available in Word 2007, PowerPoint, and Excel in Mac and Windows. Today I will create a SmartArt graphic in Word 2008 on a Mac. To begin, go to the Elements Gallery and click the SmartArt Graphics tab. The SmartArt Graphics Gallery can also be opened by going to Insert, SmartArt Graphic. There are many types of SmartArt graphics available, including List, Process, Cycle, Hierarchy, Relationship, Matrix, and Pyramid. The first example we will create today is a Process SmartArt graphic. Specifically the basic process SmartArt graphic. So we will go to process and then click on basic process. My SmartArt graphic is going to be on how to create a SmartArt graphic. I can start typing directly into the boxes. Or I can open the text pane by clicking the text pane button in the top left of the graphic. As you can see, as I type the words, they appear in the graphic and the size of the graphics and text are automatically adjusted as I type. My next text will be Select Process. And then, since I want to include Basic Process in a bullet under Select Process, I will demote the next bullet by clicking the Demote button in the text pane. Then I will type Select Basic Process into the bullet. Then, since I want to add three more shapes, I will click the Add button three more times. Oops, I want it in its own box, so I'll have to push the Promote button. I want two more shapes, so I'll have to click the Add button two more times. Oops, I clicked the Add button one too many times. To remove a shape, click the Remove button. As I click the Remove button and Add button, the graphics and text automatically resize. I then want to finish typing my text into the SmartArt graphic. After I have entered all my information, I now want to modify my SmartArt graphic. To modify my SmartArt graphic, I can follow the same steps I would in formatting any graphic. For more information on formatting a graphic, see Screencast done by Leslie and Chris. There are many different ways to use SmartArt graphics in the classroom. I have included some examples to be shown. The first example I have included is a horizontal hierarchy, used to show the different combinations possible using sandwich toppings. The second example I have created is a basic process used to show the food chain, starting with the polar bear, who eats the ring seal, who eats the Arctic cod, who eats the shrimp, who eats the algae. The third example I've included is a text cycle SmartArt graphic used to show the life cycle of a butterfly. The fourth example I've included is an equation SmartArt graphic, used to spice up showing simple addition to the lower levels of elementary school. The final example I've included is a target list, probably used in high school and upper level math. This graphic shows how natural, integer, rational, and real algebraic numbers are all included in real numbers. Thank you for watching my screencast on how to create a SmartArt graphic. I hope you enjoyed learning how to use the SmartArt graphic and implement it in the classroom.